Okay, just as you've seen that there is a 15 minutes time we have taken more actually to cover the things. So quickly I want to cover the required portions. Actually, I wanted to first highlight with respect to what is the affordable platform, because Professor Rai and others clearly mentioned if you want to involve more people, more technology and improve the life of the people, particularly the industries which are operating in the villages, then two, three things are must. Number one, we have to involve the already existing small scale manufacturing people to know that how good design can be made. They do not have any access to the best of the softwares. They do not have any access to the best of the technology. They do not have access to the best practices. Now in this scenario, what kind of digital platforms, other things we can provide to at least bring at par with them? Then only the standards and other things comes into picture. Glaring example is that how the Chinese industry, they can capture our cracker, sari and all other business, and they can flood our market, whereas they are meeting their own demands. So major challenges of the manufacturing, you can see, it's a two burden. One burden is technology upgradation and bringing them at level with the existing quality standard. And second thing, that how we can innovatively design and improve the quality of the products. So here you can see there are the key features which are involved with the inclusive manufacturing, which I foresee that is required for its upgradation and implementation. One is somehow we have to make a framework that should involve the all kind of availability of the design tools to the a team. Because simply, if we expect that each and every manufacturer will have their own design expert, that is not possible. So we have to find out some way that how this small manufacturing group can be supported. So we need, first of all, these advanced technologies. They are pertaining to the hybrid machines, semantic waves, cyber physical systems, IoTs and virtual realities in order to innovatively develop the product design. Then we have to include the people actually, because that is the everything is going for them only. And the regulations which are coming us because of the new rules framed by the international community, local community, etc. So we require a comprehensive framework. That is I wanted to discuss, because nowadays if you leave it to individuals, we are biased. So we need actually a system where, like our mouth was there long back ago, in Ramcharitmanas, Tulsidas has very clearly mentioned that Mukhiya Mukso Chahiye Khan Pan Kar Ek Palai Posai Sakalang Tulsi Sahid Bibek. The meaning of this is that, like mouth is there which distributes everything to different people as per their requirements and needs. So we require a comprehensive framework of digital platforms which can integrate the people from the design group, manufacturing group, quality group, packaging group and logistic group. Because without that, we cannot expect the things to improve. I take the simple example of any complex product. It can also be made in my village. It can also be made near to Kolkata, near to UP, Gorakhpur, Jaunpur, Allahabad, anywhere else, provided we need people who can translate the design of a device to using either CATIA or Pro Engineer, IDEAS or any kind of nowadays virtual reality linked software. But who knows this? Only chosen few persons know this. So what is the solution? You make, like we have a SME for manufacturing, we have a design SME. We require startups whose people are expert in converting the product requirement of South Africa, China, Brazil, Nepal, Bangladesh. Also, that how we can manufacture in Allahabad, Jaunpur, Gorakhpur, Patna, anywhere else. And unless otherwise, we have this kind of teamwork to convert the design and need requirement of the people of other country to our place, so that we can frame it in the basic manufacturing needs. So this is one group, that is why we call them design SME group. And they must be empowered with all kind of tools, and using the cloud, they should easily be accessible through the network-based manufacturing. This is one thing, whether you use IoT, what you call industry 4.0 standard, or we go by our own cyber physical system standard, but this is one thing that is panacea for supporting the new product design, which can help not only our local people, but also the other countries' people. And corresponding changes in the manufacturing, packaging, logistics, that is also bound to come up. And once we do it, then the people who search the market, there should also be a very effective group who can target that this product made from here, how it can go to other place. So this comprehensive integration of the systemic thinking is required actually to promote the small companies, SMEs, and startups to realize the fruits of this easily our inclusive manufacturing actually. So keeping this, I have taken a comprehensive example of pipe manufacturing. There are different kind of pipes we reach from nuclear installation to chemical plants to oil and gas to household to sewage to water distribution, etc. And they have around many varieties of the materials, etc. we require. Now question is, if we follow the framework that we support, like say digitized framework, then right from implementation to demand capturing to integration with cyber physical systems to different kind of service templates meant for meeting the specifications, and even I know if you work people, then very costly materials which are used for transporting nuclear waste in Indian systems. There was a company near Devas, I don't want to name it because this was a confidential component involved into that. Sir, we have worked with them and reduced their rate of reject from 40% to just 10% actually. So it is not like that. We have the capability, as sir has already mentioned, but we have to follow a comprehensive framework that can take care of all these things. And for that, we have simply noted down the different steps. And if you follow the framework, then we can easily see the change, that how better quality, how the skill developed by the people can be altered and can be improved, and we can make it environmental friendly. So with this, I just want to complete the terms, because there are some other things, speakers, very prominent speakers are there. And we more on pipe manufacturing, we will take our next session, which is tomorrow. Thank you, sir.